r/AskReddit. What is the creepiest thing you've seen in the woods, or in the mountains, or in deserts, or caves, or in a small towns, or in remote or rural areas, or while on large bodies of water, or while on an aircraft or a nautical vessel? I was driving home after an extremely late night at work. I lived in the middle of nowhere. About a mile before I got there, a woman covered in blood jumped out of the woods into the middle of the road screaming. I panicked and went around her, then slammed on the brakes to help. Her boyfriend had beaten her and was currently chasing after her in the woods. I got her in my car and called the police. They met us at the hospital because I told them there was no way I was waiting on the side of the road when he was coming. There's a section of Joshua Tree National Park called Samuelson's Rocks where an old Swedish prospector who lost his mind used to live. He carved all sorts of crazy sayings into the rocks. During the day they look pretty neat. At night in a lightning storm they look like something out of Lovecraft. Carlitz River, Washington State. Camping with my dad and sister, me buddies. Early 90s. Something was throwing rocks and sticks into our camp. We shined the flashlight out and caught a reflection of eyes and a Salawite. Very, very tall. Kept throwing stuff in our camp randomly for about 15 minutes. We just stoked the fire really high. In the morning I woke up to heavy footsteps in our camp and something reeked. Woke up my dad. He shook the tent and yelled. Whatever it was ran off. My girlfriend and I were hiking along some abandoned railroad tracks and we get to a small bridge going over a little creek. I'm about to go explore under the bridge when she points something out. I look over and in the woods across from us I see a guy. I'm like whatever and keep headed down to the creek area, and then the guy stands up and he's naked. We immediate backtrack pretty quickly to get away from there, and once we're like 1 minute down the trail I look back and this naked dude is just standing in the middle of the trail watching us walk away. While I was walking to high school I saw the body of a young girl that had hung herself from a swing set. Police were just putting the bag over the body when I was going by. The city ripped down the playground and built a new one shortly after. I was on a camping trip with some friends of mine and we found like 7 or 8 chipmunks and squirrels all in a pile, but they were all dead without arms or legs. Edit. This is my highest rated comment, thank you. I was a cook on board several NOAA research ships. Up in the Bering Sea. I saw what appeared to be a massive, black, triangular shaped craft dive under the water. I viewed it from a distance of maybe 2 nautical miles. I was walking with family when I was little and we came across a sheep's head. No body or blood, just a severed sheep's head on the path. It was the first time I noticed sheep's eyes have slit pupils and I think my first contact with something so gruesome. Walking on the beach with my boyfriend and we had walked to a giant rocky cliff to Makiat. Somebody was just gazing at the ocean. Crying and shaking. Mind you. This is late at night. Like around 9:30 PM. We asked him if he was okay. He apologized and practically ran back down the cliff, away from the dangerous areas. My boyfriend and I watched him until he reached the public area and decided to call it a night. I'm pretty sure he was going to jump. My friend and I were chilling in the woods one day back in high school and see a dog walking by. Later followed by this kid. He looked troubled, so we asked if he needed help. He obliged. Telling us he was dog sitting for his friend and the dog got loose. So we spent a good hour following this dog and kid around. Going deeper and deeper into the woods. Eventually I finally got the dog to come to me. But it wasn't wearing a collar, so I wasn't able to get a hold. My friend and I look away for just few seconds to discuss strategy. And when we turn back around, the boy and the dog are both gone. It was like they completely vanished. Keep in mind it was autumn, so any footsteps could be heard from quite afar. But it was just silent. Not a single trace of them anywhere. Still don't really know what happened. Maybe they ran away real quick. Who knows? Was definitely enough to creep us out though. So when I was 15, my friends and I liked to climb abandoned buildings. We found one down by the river. About 3 stories high and in pretty bad condition. I remember there were no stairs initially and we had to pull ourselves up. We climbed to the top via broken stairs after that. At the top was a small open room where someone was living. We walked in to look around and immediately noticed the walls were covered in pictures. Pictures of women tied up. naked. Obviously in pain in all sorts of positions. Some appeared dead, but they were from magazines. We never got out of a building and away from an area so fast. Looking back, it was probably just serious BDSM porn, but 15-year-old me dipped out. Doing urban exploration in a dilapidated church at night. On one of the floors was this circular motif in the floor where I guess a podium or something was. There was fresh blood on it as if something was killed there. When we went in the basement later on, we heard someone running upstairs. I'll see if I can find a picture of it. If it's in my tower PC, I probably won't be able to for a while though, since it's fried. Edit. Found it. I was Boy Scout, camping with my group of older buddies and an adult leader in Yellowstone. We had been backpacking for 2 days and stopped in a beautiful little clearing at the bottom of some huge tree-covered hills. The sun started to set. We made a fire, and I began to climb up into the trees to dig a hole and fill it back up. You know what I mean. As I squat there, basking in moonlight and appreciating the glow of fire among the trees, I looked up to a ridge line a few hundred yards away where the moon was rising. And I shit you not, I saw damn big cougar crest the hill and just watch our fire. It was likely no danger to me. But seeing that outline, that unmistakable shoulder crawl they do, was haunting. I watched it sit there for a good 15 minutes until I was called back by my worried buds. I pointed the cat out to them when I got done because it was still just watching us. Crazy. Me and a friend decided to take our 4x4s and go camping in the mountains. I wake up middle of the night because I need to take a piss. So I put on my headlamp and I walk a bit further from camp, and as I'm doing my business, I hear rocks rustle behind me as if they're being walked on. Anxiety rises. I finish up and turn around. And as my headlamp faintly lights up the area around me, all I see eyes. About 20 of them, and just staring at me. My breathing stops. And I literally freeze where I'm standing. And then I hear a Maya, goat blessed. It was a fucking herd of mountain goats that were intrigued by the ape in their backyard. Almost gave me an aneurysm. So it wasn't creepy for me, but I used to live on a farm, 200 acres, and dirt bike riders used to come on our property. Well, one night at about 10 my dad heard them coming, so he got out of bed bare ass naked with his shotgun and ran towards them. I wasn't awake for this, but my brother was, and he said it was the funniest thing he's ever seen. Imagine a bike of Viking naked man, dick swinging, with a shotgun running at you. Needless to say, they never came back after that. I found a woman's body floating in a harbor in San Pedro, CA. I saw a dude take a dump and while pooping get bit on his ass by a snake. During a Inca camp, 15-20 years ago, was around 11-13 at the time. We were camping in tents in a forest area. Was middle of summer, so stayed light till around 10 PM. 11 PM till it was fully dark. So we go on a night walk with the group and are halfway into the forest when we notice someone definitely not belonging to our group following us. Camp leaders rushed us back to camp and put us into our tents with one leader staying up to watch us. Halfway through the night, wake up and have to pee like a madman. Get out of the tent to walk to the bathroom and see the leader supposed to watch us asleep in his chair by the campfire. Look around and see that the guy following us earlier has opened up and is peeking into one of the tents, while fumbling in a bag he has next to him. Screamed louder than I ever screamed in my life. Leaders wake up. Jump the guy and hold him till the police arrive. Turns out he had a taser, blindfold, rope and several knives in his bag. While hiking on the Pacific Crest Trail, I was ready to quit for the night and saw a clear spot with no pine cones or sticks to remove. I assumed someone had cleared it before me, but when I stepped on the spot the earth sank like it had just been put there. I slept on the spot but pondered about it. The next morning it became clear that someone had dug up that spot and then covered it. I think I slept on someone's recent grave. I was hiking in northern Quebec, doing some exploration work for geologists. The thing about northern Quebec is that it has forests, mountains, hills, pretty much all green, black and gray. Except that in the middle of a forest we hiked through, we found this strange all yellow patch of grass in a perfect circle, about the diameter of a medium-sized house. It was almost perfectly flat too. Caught us off guard. was working in a forest in East Africa for a while. Was getting seriously dark and we were hiking back to the car. The wind was quite strong but you could still hear some ruffling in the leaves, and as I turned around, I saw something quite big in the shrubs. Was a fucking leopard. I shrieked and some guy from the group shot into the air to scare the animal away. I am glad he didn't shoot the animal, but was still glad when the animal bolted out of there. I was walking my dog through the woods and she'd find the odd bone. Thought nothing of it. But then she ran towards a huge black sack and was going nuts for it. I opened the bag and it's filled with bones. Kinda fucking weird, but I'm still like, okay, just be hunters around or something. But then I walk a bit further and start seeing more and more bags. Then a huge cluster of them. At least 20 right there. All filled with bones. I decided my dog had a long enough walk after seeing that. When I was really young, we were on a family trip and me and my older brother took a ride on a boat. I remember my mom telling us to avoid the big floating thing. She thought it was a buoy to signalize a dangerous rock underwater or something. Being kids, of course we went straight there to explore it. So turns out it was not a buoy. That was a body of a tourist that went missing a week ago. As the police informed us a few days later. Creepy thing is, he was one of a group of people that had disappeared together. I believe they never find the rest. So, not a good childhood memory. Sounded like babies crying. It was coyotes. Creepiest thing though was when we saw a lone person just walking through the woods in the middle of nowhere. IDKY, that's creepy, but it is when you're out there. Not sure how creepy this is. But I was on a week-long camping trip with some friends and I woke up with a weasel sitting on my chest looking at me. I never knew I could scream that loud. It's 2 a.m. We're in a tent in the woods in Maine. I'm about 8. Mom. There's something creeping around outside the tent. MMMPH. You're dreaming. Go back to bed. Mom. There really is something out there. No. There isn't. Just then. Something whops on the side of the tent. Hard enough to shake the whole thing. And my mother, who is entirely too goddamn tired to deal with this shit, sits bolt upright and whops right back in the same spot. And from outside the tent, we hear. Meow. Edit. It was a house cat. We didn't hear anything more the rest of the night. I've mentioned it on here before, but I found the body of a murdered woman in the woods when I was 10. I was collecting cans to trade in for money and walked to a party spot in the woods and she was lying face down in the grass. This was in 1997 or so, and I found out a few years ago it's become the center of a local urban legend, and the story going around is quite different than what I experienced. It messed me up pretty bad for a while. A man walking up a mountain with a cat calmly sitting perfectly still on top of his head. I was once walking through the woods and kept finding jam sandwiches cut into triangles and deliberately lined up on logs or stacked in careful little piles on the ground. Literally about 30 sandwiches worth of triangles spread over about 1 kilometer. Like the Blair Witch Project, but with jam sandwiches. Fucking weirdest thing I've ever come across. Not creepy per se. But definitely scared the shit out my friends and I. Made on property that we didn't know was restricted. It was right around sundown. We had hiked for a while to a clearing we had been at many times. On a ridge point 2-5 miles away or so. See a woman on a horse. Bottles are falling out of her saddle and she seemed inebriated. She was slurring and yelling at us about her property. And then pulled out a revolver and fired multiple shots in our direction. So we ran scared shitless and never went back there. Posted about this before. But back when I was a kid, some friends and I came across people in robes chanting around a campfire out in the woods on the edge of the town we lived in. We were staying at a friend's house for a birthday party sleepover and went for a late night walk. This was back in the late 80s during the satanic panic. Looking back now, I'm sure it was just some teenagers goofing around. But at the time it scared the living bejesus out of us. One of the girls with us had a panic attack and started hyperventilating. Got pretty serious. But we finally managed to get her calmed down. It was dark and I was sitting around a bonfire with 4 friends in rural North Carolina. We had been drinking and they had smoked a bit. I wasn't at the time, and were taking turns telling stories. A lull came in the conversation and the black silhouette of a sixth person stood up and faded into the surrounding darkness. We decided that we'd had enough for the night and packed everything up before walking back to a friend's house. All five of us swear there was a sixth person there but don't remember any kind of discernible characteristic besides they seemed to be covered in shadow. I was driving through rural parts of Missouri with a buddy. We drove down a single lane road that had no exit. At the end of the road, there was a group of deer corpses laid in a perfect circle. I'd say there was at least 10 deer. We BTFO real quick. Edit. Spelling. When I was a kid, I used to live on a tiny property in the woods. My house was basically built around where stables were once. My room was, back when it was still stables, where the hay was stocked. Before getting to the creepy thing, I need to say some other stuff. When you were in my room, you could sometimes smell hay out of nowhere. My dog was always refusing to go upstairs because something was scaring the shit out of it there. You could sometimes hear knocking on doors. There were three entrance doors in my house. Sometimes all at once. Now that this have been said, we can go to the fun thing. So my room had a big ass window that gave a big view over the woods and my garden was basically a clearing. Once, I fucking heard a kid giggling from upstairs. I ran there only to find my window open and something running out in the woods. I spent 2 more years in this house and fucking felt insecure the whole time. Edit. For those who think kids were pranking me, I highly doubt that any kid would survive such a fall from my room into the garden plus private property. The only entrance has a big ass portal that is inconvenient to climb. I was delivering a sailboat from San Diego to Morro Bay, California, roughly 25 miles offshore alone. At around 1 a.m. about 36 hours into the trip, I saw a bright glowing blue orb around 30 feet in diameter just below the surface at my 1 o'clock. It was a moonless night which made the blurry sphere contrast well against the seemingly black water around it. My first thought was, oh shit, a fast attack submarine is surfacing, not uncommon in that area. I started desperately looking for a yellow flare in the water, maritime warning for a soon to be surfacing sub, but couldn't find one. It fluctuated in size and moved very slowly, so I quickly ditched the submarine theory. After some time I ended up idling and put the boat into irons to just watch it for a while. When it finally broke the surface in a large, bright, and loud boil, I realized what I had been watching. Turns out it was a large school of sardines swimming together, agitating the bioluminescence that happened to be present that night. It still stands out as one of the most bizarre experiences I've had on the water and I will never forget it. Not in any of those places, but I was a kid and was in this hotel-like place. Went to public toilet. Guy walks in. Gray skin. Eyes, pupils really small like a zombie's eyes. He was just staring at me. Safe to say I got out of Dodge real fast. Felt like running at night last year because the park near where I live gets all pretty with the lights on in the dark. So after 5 minutes into the exercise, I feel the need to adjust my shoes because I forgot to wear a longer sock and they were hurting my ankle. I look up and I see this dark silhouette running towards me at full speed wearing a hoodie about 50 meters away. I was on the left side of the street and he was on the right, so it was clear he was running towards me. I legit almost shitted my pants and felt an adrenaline surge. I thought about fighting him if he got any closer. But in a blink of an eye, the person trips, falls face planted on the ground, and starts crawling in my fucking direction again. Fuck that. Dude is committed. I'm leaving. Edit. Some people mentioned the scene from Get Out. It was exactly like that, but he fell halfway through. I was jogging at night with headphones on in a park with dense trees and bushes. The overgrowth was taking over the path and it was difficult to see, so I turned the flashlight on my phone on. I started to see a fire burning ahead but couldn't really make it out. I take my glasses off when I jog. As I got closer, there's a clearing and I see a big fire raging and no one around. So I pause a minute and fish my glasses out and find out that yes, there's 6 people standing there actually. Perfectly spaced apart from each other, and they all turned at the same time to look at me. I turned 180 and sprinted the fuck out of there. Edit. The path I jog on at night is nice and bright because the city of Winnipeg uses those LED street lights now. The wooded area leads to a small area called Don Garry Park. where I get to a bench and take a minute to reflect on my day and my goals for tomorrow. Also the bench I rest at it right beside this police launch dock for the Red River. I have never not felt safe there. My friends and I have speculated that the six dudes I saw were probably police just blowing off steam on a quiet night. Camping with three girls at a campsite far out in the woods with nobody else around for miles. The temp had dropped to 39°F and we were freezing our asses off after tripping on shrooms all day and smoking to keep warm. We heard a weird laughter and then screaming in the woods near us. It was actually terrifying because we couldn't identify if it was a child or something else. One time my buddies and I decided to go for a walk at the cemetery at night. Because it scared the shit out of one of my friends. And the rest of us are assholes. We were roaming around. Until our scared friend started freaking out and pointed out that he saw some weird people. We thought he was just paranoid. But when we looked, there were indeed three or four figures further back in the cemetery. Wearing hooded cloaks of some sort. They were surrounding some large grave. With an angel statue that we passed earlier. We all freaked out for a sec. Till we saw the figures grouped together around the grave with one of them taking their picture. We concluded that they must have been in a local band that needed an edgy album cover. This isn't nearly as creepy as other stuff. One time I was hiking in a state park near my house with my boyfriend. The park was deserted and we decided to stop at a little tiny body of water in the brush. There had recently been a lot of rain, so it made this fairy-sized lake with a waterfall feeding into it. It was super pretty. So as we're standing there admiring a tiny paradise, I start to hear growling. I honestly thought I was imagining things, so I kept listening. It sounded like a low animalistic growling. I turned to my boyfriend and said jokingly, "I hear growling," thinking he would dismiss it, but he said, "Me too." I spun around and quickly scanned everywhere around us, but we looked to be alone. We quickly moved on and kept hiking. Still don't know what the hell that was about, lol. I was hiking deep in a desert canyon during the middle of night. Pitch black. No moon, dense shrubbery. And I saw a pair of eyes at about waist level. I stood tall and walked with the two headlamps facing forward and back. Every time I looked back for the next several miles, those eyes were locked onto me. Whatever it was that was stalking me never made a sound. There was no crunch of rocks or sand. No rustling in the bushes. Just the illumination of unblinking eyes peering back at me. Was camping a couple of years ago when I heard movement outside my tent, thinking it was my friend. I called out to him, but there was no answer. After a minute the movement stopped, so I left my tent and sat outside it for a while. 10 minutes passed when my friend that I thought had been moving came out of his tent looking for his phone. He denied that it was him who was outside the tent. It was only him, myself and my GF at the time, so I said it must have been an animal. At that point we both heard something move very close to us and saw the silhouette of a person watching us. Don't ask me why, but we both got up and started to approach the person, who began to run away. We chased him her for a minute but gave up when we noticed them drop stuff from their hand. Not only did they drop my friend's phone that he couldn't find, but mine and my girlfriend's as well. The person was in our tents. I'd been at football training with a few of my cousins when I was about 10 years old. We decided to take a walk before our parents picked us up. So we went along the canal towpath. My cousin looked down in the canal and saw a really nice jacket floating along, and being a weird scavenger person decided to reach in to fish it out. Well, the jacket turned over. And so did the man wearing it. He also had no face left. Not gonna lie. That was rough. Not super creepy. But I was walking in the woods. And walked for a bit. Heard a crack to my left. So I turned my head. There stood a moose. Not only a moose. But a fawn as well. I just walked slowly backwards until I built enough courage to turn around and sprint the fuck out of there. Moose are really aggressive when they're with their children. If anyone wonders. In my village, just a little too small to be a small town, I saw a person in a white full bodysuit with helmet. They were in the bush. It was one of those suits you can wear so you don't get stung by nettles. Point being, they were in the bush. Then he or she looked at me and then looked at me and backed up into the bush like Homer did in that meme format. Needless to say, I legged it across two upfield hills. I just reread it a day after cause it got all those upvotes, and upfield hill is probably a very smart thing. This happened 7 years back. I was living in a rented house where we had two bathrooms. One of them was broken and unusable. It smells really bad when you open the bathroom door. I always have this one bolted and locked. One night, a thunderstorm was approaching the city. The power went off since the winds were too strong. I was there sitting all alone in the living room when I heard thudding sound coming from the bathroom. I thought it could be because of the air pressure difference due to the thunderstorm. Continued on to do my assignments. And there was a loud thud and I swear I saw the bathroom door open. I freaked out and left the house and stayed at the terrace until the power came. I don't know where the lock went and how the fuck it opened. When I went back in, the door was partly closed. Locked it tight and tied it with a rope. Obviously I chickened out of that house in a couple of weeks. Never going near there again. Edit. No visible creepy thingy. Just the setting creeped the shit out of me. Was in the woods at a school sponsored event to learn more about nature. All kids had cabins they slept in and on one side of the wall were windows stacked on top of each other, 2x2. We all woke up from either a bear roaring or a demon. And all the bottom row windows busted. But the glass went outside. So some kind of blast came from inside. I was in elementary. Went camping for wife and I's anniversary 1 year in Payson near the rim. Went to bed. So eerie to hear nothing but the wind in the pines. Finally fell asleep. Woke up with paralysis and a red light glowing outside our tent. The light got brighter and something started unzipping our tent. I was frozen in place just staring at the flap being unzipped. When the flap was almost opened, I was able to move my head and look at my wife's face. She had this horrible look of fear. Mouth agape and everything. When she started to scream I woke up. With nothing but the wind and the pine and pitch black. Nothing opened our tent. And we were still laying where we fell asleep. Do I think it was a nightmare? Yeah. I'm terrified of aliens and stories about them. Maybe it was my brain messing with me. Or was it a repressed memory? Who knows? Scared the shit out of me. We left the next day. This will get buried and it's long but whatever. To set the scene. Me, 11 years old, and my mom tent camping in Yellowstone National Park. My mother is terrified of bears. Okay so. We get our tent set up. Have dinner. Go to bed. Next thing you know we hear gunshots. Reason? To scare off wildlife close by. That didn't sit well with mom. But we both managed to fall asleep. Sometime during the night I'm woken up with my mom yell whispering "Lyrice a fat cat. Wake up. There's a bear. I can hear a bear growling outside. There's a bear. Fuck. Holy shit. Bear. Now I'm an 11 year old girl. I can't fend off a bear. So I try to tell her to calm down and relax. Be quiet. But she's not having it. So finally I hear this growly, grumbly, rustling sound outside but it doesn't sound like what I'd imagine a bear to sound like. Mum's still freaking out because we're going to get eaten. More growling sounds and then we hear "Honey, shut the fuck up. Roll over. You're too loud." Turns out mom's bear was the husband in the next tent snoring his face off. Old white school buses on my parents' property. Full of personal items from the crackheads who lived on our land before they were murdered and we moved there. I went to a lake to see my grandma's friend with her and this lady found a dead body in the water. News came and there was a lot of screaming. Edit. I leave for 11 hours and holy fuck what happened, why is this popular, I don't understand, I'm gonna go and suck a blood somewhere else, yo this made me so happy. I remember going camping w my buddies. On the way there. We stopped by a small town. The car had heated up so we had to stop somewhere. We decided to park by a church. Right when my friend drove into the parking space I noticed how everyone, literally everyone, turned back at us at the same time. That gave me the creeps. It was like a scene straight out of a horror movie, lol. They were dressed in old-fashioned clothing. Kids were playing W jump ropes. Signing nursery songs. Holding hands, jumping and singing in a circle. Etc. I felt their eyes on us the whole time. That shit gave me weird vibes. We decided to leave and park somewhere else. Went walking in the woods while camping with an old boyfriend to where the road ended and found a giant underground cage. After exploring we started kissing and suddenly heard little kids giggling all around us. hightailed it out of there and never looked back. Found a deer with its hind end ate up. Few feet away was a coyote with the hind end ate up. Then another few feet away a fox with its hind end ate up. Nothing else was there. No bullet holes or signs of an arrow or anything else. Couldn't find any tracks from other people or animal. It was pretty creepy. Found in the hills of WV. I was mountain biking in the woods and I came across an East Asian looking man in a perfectly fitted suit and a briefcase. Just casually walking through the woods. I am a night owl, so used to stay up late at the computer lab on my university campus. It was open until 2 a.m. I was walking home and there were about 4-6 people covered in burlap robes and giant hoods. Sitting cross-legged on the quad. The next morning. Those fuckers were still there. It was a chicken wire and burlap fucking art piece. Edit. Words. I work as an autopsy technician. It's pretty regular happening. And doesn't faze me now. But the first time I heard a remains exhale moan was pretty creepy. If you want to get nothing in return, you can like and join my Discord. There is a link in the description.